Let me give it to you straight, alright? See, I was going to put part 3 of my 3 Girls, 1 Summer. It was going to be today. But I was talking to my friend Jordan yesterday. We was playing Madden, alright? It's not recorded. We was just chilling, talking, just reminiscing. In our friendship with my friend group and how we became friends and all that, how blessed we were to meet these people. And then I got to thinking, we were both talking about how we started not caring about people's opinions after a certain time. He stopped caring during sophomore year after he was humiliated. I stopped caring about people's opinions in junior when I was depressed. See, when I keep thinking about it, I'm like, look, we have our real friends and we got those fake friends. Alright? When fake friends is always there, no matter where you go, you can spot them easily, but they stick on you like a magnet. Okay? I was just chilling. I woke up today. I did some of my homework, you know, catching up. I just finished doing the gameplay of Trials of Mana. Because Jordan's little brother loves me playing it. He loves watching my channel. And I do it for him. I do it for my 84 subscribers. I look at my Instagram. I'm just looking at my messages because I hate getting notifications, so I always look at my messages. And I look at this dude's story, and all I see is my face. And remember, this is, I'm gonna let you know who it was. His name is Jason Lee. Jason is the dude that Voice of Reason dated, the one who I hated, right? And he posted on his story, yo, stop sneak dissing people. Sneak dissing people. I'm not sneak dissing anybody. Not a person. I'm telling a story from my point of view. Again, I put that in a disclaimer. Disclaimer, alright? I put a whole disclaimer saying that this isn't my point of view. If you have your opinions, please take it up with me, but I won't take the video down. If you got a problem, say it to me. But you posted on your story. I haven't sneak dissed anybody at all. Matter of fact, Jason. I never snuck dissed you at all in my life. Every time we saw each other, I dissed you in person. I never said, if everything I said to other people about you, I said it to your face. So I don't know where this sneak dissing is coming from. So back. See, I just want to get that back to fake friends. Back to fake friends. So with these fake friends, you know, when I let people know that I was depressed, you know the first thing they said, oh, if only I knew, I would have helped you. I said, no, you would not. Matter of fact, you didn't even notice something was wrong with me at all. See, I won't blame certain people because only certain people I know that who my real friends, they either they haven't seen me Like, we don't have any classes together. They barely see me. We only speak every once in a while. Like, Jonathan Big Sexy, who I mentioned in the first Mrs. Dear Girl video, he didn't know I was depressed. But he knew something was wrong. He knew that I had a problem. I told him. And he did kind of talk to me a little bit, even though I ignored it. What's the reason? She knew I was depressed because I told her that I was depressed. Everybody I told that I was a real friend that was depressed, they at least tried to console me, trying to help me out in any shape or fashion. Jordan Joseph, the guy I play Madden with, he did not know I was depressed until I told him. You know why? Because he was in a different place. He wasn't in Italy when I became depressed. He was in Washington, and I didn't tell him till this year because he moved to another place and he was living his life. Why would I project my problems onto you when you're in a whole different place? I didn't want to project any more problems with anybody. But some people knew. But when I tell these fake friends, oh man, I was depressed. Aww. I'm sorry that happened to you, man. But where were you at when I needed? I'm always there for you when you have a problem. You always come to me to help you out. But when I need you, you're nowhere to be found at all. See, Jamie, the girl I told you who helped me during my depression, she didn't even know that she helped me in my depression because I put up a front because I was trying to get with her. Of course she didn't know. See, I don't blame her for not knowing. That was just me faking. Okay, but when I told her, I said, I thank you for helping me out. I think of you as somebody I love. Not in love, but I love you as a person because you helped me out indirectly. Okay? But you fake friends, the first thing you always say is that I care about you. You know I care about you. I'm like, I don't. Because let me explain this. Oh, since I'm sneak dissing, let me put these people's names out here. So Alice and Shay, I made the misunderstanding of real stories. I thought it was funny. Other people thought it was funny. I think there was only one mistake I made about making that story, and I tagged them in an Instagram post saying that, hey guys, this story is about us. I did it as a joke because I was like, yo, I don't take the situation seriously because that happened way back a year ago. We're all living our lives. I'm here, y'all in Italy, y'all got a boyfriend, you got a girlfriend. Oh, I'm free to tell the story because we have no problems. We're good. We're friends. So, we're friends. What? Did you only care about me when I was in Italy helping you out? Or I was dealing with your emotions? Or when I gave you satisfaction? But what about me? Huh? What about me? So, when I made this story, I did it as a joke. It was clowning me. I was being a clown. Hashtag Mrs. Your Girl was just a friend. But when I got a message at my job, hey, Malik, why did you make us look like hoes? Not one person that I know who saw my video said that I called y'all hoes or implied that at all. They are the reason that I made a disclaimer. I had to make a disclaimer, okay? Because of those two. Because of they interpret that I call them hoes. Now we're in this problem. And you know the first thing she said to me? Malik, you know I care about you. I said, in my head, I'm like, if you care about me, this should not be enough to break our friendship. And I only apologize. I'm like, I'm sorry if I made it look like I said I was hoes. You know I didn't call you a hoe. I know I didn't call you that. But you, I was with you from thick and thin. But the moment I say something, we're broken off. That says something about my friendship. It was like I'm putting on energy into that. I told Shay, I apologize to you. I'm sorry if I made you think like that. She says, I wake up the next morning. She says, I'm used to guys making me look like a hoe. I didn't make you look like a hoe. I was just telling everybody what happened in my point of view. I never called y'all. I said y'all broke up with these two dudes and ended up being with me. That's not a hoe. If anything, that makes me a guy who stole you from another dude. Call me a side nigga. Nothing to do with you being hoes at all. If you think you're a hoe, then I guess that's what it is. What can I do? Our friendship is broken because of it. Really? That is enough to take a friendship away. Me making a story that we know, everybody knows this story, and I just retold in my point of view, everybody, to their mothers, their fathers, their brothers, their sisters, their whole entire family, knows about what we did, because I know you told other people, and I know she told other people, but when I tell other people, it's a problem. Now, if you told me to keep it between us, that's a different story. Like, then I understand why you're mad at me. I just can't deal with these people. Like, I'm the one who gets the blame. I'm the bad guy. No matter how much I try to be the good guy, I'm just a bad guy. That's why. When I need you the most, you're not. But when you need me the most, I'm your Superman, your Spider-Man, any hero that you want, your brother, your boyfriend, your one and only. I'm there. But when I need you, you're not. I know you're a fake friend, but when I say something, I'm dissing somebody. Really? I'm dissing somebody. I'm just telling you from my point of view of what happened. Let me tell you something, Jason, okay? I know when you tell people about your stories, about what you have done, that means you're secretly dissing them also, I guess. That's how sneak dissing works. Sneak dissing means that I'm talking about you behind your back and never said nothing to you. Let me explain. Everything I've said in these stories, I told to the person's face. Because I have balls, Jason. You don't. So I need you to stop talking that spice. If you can't even come to me to talk about how I'm sneak dissing people, you put in a whole story, and then when I commented on your story, you took it off. So I don't want to hear your crap. I don't want to hear nobody's crap. If I'm the bad guy, then I'll play the bad guy. Don't ever come at me. Before I roast you in front of the whole world, and you know I'll do it, I'll do it to your face. I'll FaceTime you, because I bet you when I FaceTime you, you want me to answer it. Because you want to stick to your texting. Texting, I can only say a few words. Put me on FaceTime. And I'll roast you. I'll put you on blast. Make you stop talking your spice, and I bet you'll back away. So don't come at me if you're not ready to handle me. Jesus. Oh my God, y'all annoying. Pieces of shit. Oblivion, all cold oblivion.
is. I won't dare say that you should stop the fucking ignorance. Murder ops, killing shit. I'd enjoy the thrill of it.